Today I'm going to show you a little bit about C programming that you probably don't see anywhere else. This is some up-to-date introductory C programming on Linux. What we're going to do is make a... we'll include the standard headers. And along with we're going to include wide character support here in our program. Now we know what headers to use by reading the man page for wprintf. It'll tell us to include wchar.h. So now we're going to make a function that returns int and accepts a wide character input. And we're going to have it return the result of that. We just made a wrapper to wprintf, is all we did. It's a very simple function. It just prints a string. We'll create the main entry point. And we're just going to have it return our function. The backslash n there tells it to print a new line. Oh yeah, and don't forget that wide strings begin with a capital L. And save it. And now we're going to compile it. We just tell it to the O. GCC is the name of our compiler. And then this O option, dash O. And then the program name, this is the output name, and then this is the name of the source file we're using, hi.c. And it's compiled. And you can see we've got hi and hi.c there. And if we run our program, it prints out, hi there. That's our message, and that's our program. All right, that's done. Let's debug it now. There we go. We can debug it with GDB. We didn't include debugging symbols, so we get a nice disassembly when we view it with GDB. And you can see the breakpoint is automatically set to main, and this machine language instruction sub here, all that does is subtract 4 from the stack pointer. Now the stack grows down, it grows downward in memory, so subtracting 4 tells it that we're going to add 4 bytes to the stack. See, subtracting is adding. Aha, how does that work? And this isn't confusing to anyone. Yeah, the stack grows down. So if you want to add 4 bytes to the stack, you subtract 4 from the stack pointer. Okay, moving right along. This move long instruction right here. That just takes this number and puts that onto the stack. What it's doing is it copies that to the memory on the stack. Those 4 bytes we allocated on the stack now holds this number, which is the address. What is that address? Well, let's see. Well, we've got the H out of it anyway. If we keep printing, see, GDB can't print strings, it just can't do it. So if we just keep going and adding 4, we can eventually start to see the message. We've got T, the next one will be H, and so on. why that's not working now. But anyway, we don't have to worry about that. We know what's in that address now. And we can use the SI instruction to step into single step. So we know we've called, or we're going to call my function with this string, and we know it says hi there. So we just keep stepping into it. Now we're in my function, and we're just doing some fancy stuff with the stack now. We're just pulling the address off the stack and then just put it back on again. The compiler wasn't sure what we were going to do there, so it just pulled the address off and put it back on. And now it's calling wprintf, the actual function. And what's it calling it with? Well, it's calling it with the string that we just took off and put back on the stack. And that location is, it should still be in the EAX register right here. And if we wanted to print that, we could. Use printx. That gets the address, the one that contains hi there. Anyway, if we continue the program, it'll print out our string like that. That's GDB. We can debug programs using GDB. But what if we don't? What if GDB doesn't work, or if we didn't include any symbols in there? There's another way we can hack this program, and that is we can use hexdump on it. That looks like junk there. We've got the first 16 bytes here, and we see that it's an ELF program. We could also go file. File would tell us some information about it. It says it's a 32-bit LSB executable. Bunch of stuff there. We can also go readelf, and that looks at the header. And one cool thing about readelf is it tells you the entry point address. We can use that for disassembly. If we use ndisasm, the U option tells us that we're disassembling a 32-bit executable. The offset, that's our offset. And we're going to use a, we're going to skip some header bytes, 320 there off the end. And there's our program, and we're going to pipe the output through less. Now, that's not our program yet, but this is the entry point, and it's setting up the stack here, and then it puts this address onto the stack, and then calls the libc function that in turn will call our program. This is the address of our program, and this is the program loader. We want to look at our program, so we'll disassemble this address right here. We're going to go to it. We go dash I to go to case insensitive searching, and we just type in the address right there, and it finds it. This is the start of our program, and you'll recall when we looked at it under GDB, we're subtracting 4 bytes from the stack. Stack moves downward, so we're actually pushing this address onto the stack. And you'll notice that we're using the Intel format now for the Intel syntax for disassembly that has the operands on the right and the target on the left. So